peace be with.
Hello? Peace. Hello? No. Hello? Hi. Peace be with you. We're so grateful that you're here today. What a joy it is to be together again this season to celebrate the 50th anniversary of Avant Music, sure, but even more to just remember what it feels like to be in the same room and to experience what music can do in our lives when we share it generously and experience it together. I'm very thankful to so many people who have made today possible. A lot of you are in this room right now. Those of you who have given your gifts of time and talent and treasure to make Abend Music possible these many years. Particularly today, I want to thank our season sponsors, First-Plymouth Church. It's a beautiful place for a concert, yeah? The Lincoln Community Foundation, the Nebraska Arts Council, the Conant Family Endowments, the estate of Norma Sommerheiser, Union Bank and Trust, and our friends John and Joan Michelson. Please join me in thanking them for making this all possible. And today's program in particular is a gift of two of our longtime concert sponsors and wonderful friends. I'd like to particularly thank Matthew and Ann Finkner for their gifts for today. Thank you. And because so many of you contributed on Give to Lincoln Day, the Lincoln Community Foundation gave us a wonderful matching grant that also joins in sponsoring this particular concert today. So thanks again to them. We gather today, in addition to experiencing this music, to also be mindful of the community and the neighborhood that we're so blessed to be a part of here. And one of the great treasures is the Malone Community Center. They do incredible work with families in our Lincoln area. And we're so grateful that all of the donations that you might offer today on your way out will be gifted to the Malone Center and enable their incredible work to continue. We're grateful to play a small role in that today. I've got it. Oh, yeah, thank you. One of the great parts of my jobs, I guess, is that I have the pleasure of inviting people to our community to bring music for us to experience together. And I've never felt, honestly, that privilege more profoundly than today when I can welcome the Jason Max Ferdinand Singers to be here as they're beginning their journey and starting out on their mission of spreading hope and enriching cultural health. My goodness, how I hope we as Abend Music are part of that mission too. And how great to join them hand in hand today. I invited them here before they ever really existed, actually. So I had that much faith in these people. And I can tell after having been in worship with them today especially, that my faith was not unfounded. And that they have a lot of faith and hope and light to bring to us today. My friends, would you join me in welcoming warmly, for the first time in Lincoln or Nebraska or the Midwest and just about anywhere, the Jason Max Ferdinand Singers.
Thank you.
Praise the Lord. Life is a journey. And to journey is to embrace change. And though we sit in the shadow of the halls of erudition and scholarship and theology, and though we walk on an established path in the echoing footsteps of academia and church, we are also creating new paths that must be built. And these new roads and these new bridges can only be built and erected by those who comprise humanity. It is harder to build than to destroy. To build is to participate and change. In jazz, we call these progressing harmonies changes. Changes are like obstacles on a speed course. They demand our attention and require us to be present. They are coming, they are here, and then they are gone. And COVID-19 is such an example. It's how life comes. Each moment is a procession from the future into the past, and the sweet spot is always the present. We are so thrilled to be with you here in Nebraska. It's much warmer than we anticipated, and that's excellent. And we hope that this experience this evening will leave all of us, including those of us up here, changed and better equipped and fit to tackle all of these social maladies which we now see. We want to sing now a setting of Psalm 1. When I was a little boy growing up, we had our equivalent of the Boy Scouts, I guess, the Adventurer Club, and we had to learn how to recite this text. This is exactly from the King James Version of the Bible and composed by a wonderful man, wonderful teacher, wonderful conductor, Dr. Nathan Mitchell Carter. This is Psalm 1.
Thank you.
don't know about you, but that composition reminds me so much of Brahms. And I love Brahms. I'm going to bring forward now a former student of mine that through the course of my travels, I met him on a small little island called the Bahamas and had such an amazing voice. And we convinced him to move from marine biology to music. And I'm going to ask Louis to come forward now and share that wonderful hymn setting of He Hideth My Soul in the Cleft of the Rock.
Savior is Jesus my Lord, a wonderful Savior to me. He hideth my soul in the cleft of the rock, where rivers of pleasure I see. Hideth my soul in the cleft of the rock that shadows a dry, thirsty land. He hideth my life in the depths of his love and covers me there with his hand, and covers me there with his hand. A wonderful Savior is Jesus my Lord. He taketh my burden away. He holdeth me up, and I shall not be moved. He giveth me grace as my day. He hideth my soul in the cleft of the rock that shadows a dry, thirsty land. He hideth my life in the depths of his love and covers me there with his hand, and covers me there with his hand. When clothed in his brightness, transported I rise to meet him in clouds of the sky. His perfect salvation, his wonderful love, I'll shout with the millions on high. He hideth my soul in the cleft of the rock that shadows a dry, thirsty land. He hideth my life in the depths of his love and covers me there with his hand and covers me there. He covers me there.
I was about to say we can all go home now. That was awesome. That was awesome. From the hymn tradition, we want to go to some Negro spirituals. And the Negro spirituals, if you know, had different purposes, yeah? Some of them were meant as a communicative tool. Some of them were meant to simply pass on in an oral way the Bible stories that they heard in church. This next spiritual just does just that. Didn't it rain all night long? And you'll hear some wonderful soloists coming at you, and I believe they're all printed in your program. So this is Didn't It Rain? That was fun. That was fun, didn't it? All right. We are so privileged up here to have who I call probably the most multifaceted musician I know. This gentleman is the music director for a gentleman by the name of Kirk Whalum, the jazz saxophonist. I Will Always Love You, Whitney Houston. And that saxophone solo we hear there, that's Kirk Whalum. John plays pipe organ, he orchestrates, he sings. I'm going to ask John now to play a setting of that Negro spiritual, Soon I Will Be Done with the Troubles of the World. And Tom, I'm going to apologize now if we do any damage to the piano, okay? This may sound bad, but I'm waiting for the day when Roderick just doesn't have voice. I mean, he just always has voice. That's just crazy. Wow. This has been a very trying pandemic, hasn't it been? Physically, emotionally, it's been draining. But you know, humanity has gone through such moments before, yeah? And the slaves went through the same thing, and someone, one of them penned the spiritual, says, "Nobody knows the trouble that I've seen." And I'm sure each of us in this room can identify with that sentiment or know someone who has and who can identify with that sentiment. We've lost so many people. Is it over 700,000 now in this nation alone? But the slaves had a hope, and they knew that somebody does know. And we all in this room know who that person is. So this is Norman Lubos, "Nobody Knows the Trouble I've Seen." That spiritual was recorded, John, back in 1956, I believe. Isn't that amazing? Mallory, I'm going to ask you to start making your way down to your instrument. Mallory McHenry is one of our proud Oakwood University graduates. She came to us as an undergrad and went very quickly through the process and just graduated with her doctorate in harp performance at the end of the last semester. So let's give her a hand. And now as a university professor down there in the state of Texas, or the country of Texas, however you choose to say it. I'm sorry. Mallory, what are you playing? That hymn arrangement? She's going to play that hymn arrangement, "Sing Them Over Again to Me, Wonderful Words of Life." Some of you know it. Enjoy. Might as well. Mallory, can we actually go back to the harp? It was just so good. There's a a wonderful, remember that concert back in, I forget the year, Kathleen Battle, Jesse Norman? It's on YouTube, you could go look it up, it's a classic. And there's a very fun arrangement there that Kathleen Battle does, and I've asked Mallory and Anika to see if they could, they're gonna do better than that, I know it, it's gonna be amazing. All right. Just showing off today. Yeah. One of our members who could not be here today, his name is Dr. Cedric Dent. Cedric is a professor of music at Middle Tennessee State University, but he made a name for himself in another group that you may recognize. Do you know the name of the group called Take Six?
Yeah.
And Cedric was the original baritone in the group Take Six, and he sings baritone in this group, which still blows my mind. But Cedric penned this arrangement of He's Got the Whole World in His Hands. And it's a combination of choral music, South Africa, and you'll hear some of that language towards the end, and Take Six. He's Got the Whole World in His Hand. Leonard? The story is told of the Fisk Jubilee Singers, who were the pioneers, if you were, for the historically black college and university choir tradition. Fisk Jubilee Singers represented their institution when they were in dire need of financial structure and financial support. So, director decided to take them on a tour. Took them on a tour of Europe, and they thought that the Europeans would want to hear classical music. And after a few concerts, the audiences started saying, we like this, but we want to hear the music that you sing. So they flipped the program in the middle of the tour and went back to the music of the spirituals. And the story is told, they were singing for a royal family, and I believe they were singing this next spiritual. And most of the people, if not all the people in the audience, were moved to tears. The spiritual that says, steal away to Jesus.
Thank you.
as the slaves were coming across in those ships, oftentimes you could hear these moans coming from the belly of the ship. And one of the songs that we sing around the world, you could sing this melody all around the world and people will recognize it. Some musicologists believe that that song was one of those tunes that was heard from the belly of those ships. Melody was very, very haunting and very painful and yearning for a chance to be free. This is a point in the concert where I'm just taking a whole left turn, so forget the program, right? John, just put me in a D major. Andrea, could I put you on the spot right here? Could you just come forward? This is the kind of stuff you just don't try at home right now. Don't do this now. Actually, John, put me in D flat. And let's all sing this together.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me.
Point to yourself and say, I.
I was lost, but now I found, was blind, but now I see.
And choir, I'm going to actually just hum this verse, and if you ad-lib, just ad-lib. Like, this is the bottom of the ship now.
Once was lost.
sometimes in our tradition, we kind of take it to church a little bit with a hop.
School, we would just simply say, praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God. Praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God. Praise God, praise God, praise God. Oh, 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 praise God, praise God.
It's okay to put your hands together.
Praise God, you're gonna praise God. On tonight we will praise God, praise God, praise God, yeah.
Thank you so much, Andre and John and Tommy. Thank you so much. Praise God. Oh, that just messed me up all the way. They led my Lord away. Can someone please tell me where we can find him? This is a spiritual that I've never heard before. And clearly, one of those spirituals where the slaves were trying to pass on this story. A beautiful setting set by Mr. Brandon Waddles. They led my Lord away.
Thank you.
There's so many soloists up here, and I wish I could get through everyone in one program. It's almost, it's impossible. I want to sing a song that's dear to me, especially in our household, in my immediate household. And I wrote this 3 years ago when my baby girl was born. And it's simply called Safe in His Arms, Safe in Daddy's Arms, but ultimately Safe in His Arms. Hopefully this sentiment will be captured that I wouldn't have to explain anymore. Safe in His Arms.
Thank you.
As Tom shared in his introduction, Tom invited us to this program, to this wonderful church, and the group had not yet even been formed. And Tom is a great man of faith. And on a serious note, I've met numerous people across this country, and we all agree that Tom is one of the closest human beings I know that reminds me of what I think of an angel. So Tom, thank you so much for this invitation. And your associate minister of music, Ariel, is someone that I knew years and years ago. And you guys are lucky to have him, and he's lucky to be here. I mean, really. and I can't see them, but Tom and Ariel, could you come towards me right now? Where are you? In the balcony, start coming now. I'll filibuster till you make it. And this morning, I was rushing in, and I met this gentleman who was so enthusiastic, and he had a radio type of a voice. And he introduced himself to the choir as Jim. And, and I had to make it clear to them that he was the head prelate of this church. Where's Pastor Jim? Is he here? Where is he? Is he here? So, Angela, could you just grab on that chair right there and just on the seat right there? You guys are so fortunate that we have our first recording project that we recorded in March in the midst of this pandemic. And this is going to be released on November 19th. What day did I say? And what's the date today? The 7th. Okay, so this is early. And Tom, we, all of us up here, wanted to present you. This is the very first one I've given to anyone outside of us. That's how much we think of you. And thank you so much for putting this together and your faith, your man of faith. So thank you so much. And Ariel, I'm so proud of you, man. And man, this is a wonderful space. And Darren, we'll have to, this is Azriel's here, but we'll get Ariel's, all right? So, thank you so much, man, for everything.
Thanks, really.
And we'll leave this one here for your pastor. So I know you're just burning right now to figure out how can you get your hands on one of these, right? Yeah. And we have, this is going to be released on the 19th. We have in the back, just for Nebraska, many of these CDs that you can get if you look right back there. And Darren, just raise your hand really high. Raise it high. That's Darren back there. You can go to Darren, and he can make sure that you get one of these. Do not impoverish yourself. Get one, okay? You will enjoy it. You're so, so welcome. Can we give them a hand, Tom and Ariel? On yesterday, after rehearsal, we went down the street across town. I don't even know where we went, and visited a little church there called Allen Chapel. And the pastor there is a young man that I taught in high school and in university. This is Pastor Marcus Larivaux. Could you stand, Marcus?
Thank you so much.
I'm really, really proud of you, man. Really proud of you. You want to come up and say something? I saw you stepping, so I don't know. Okay. I'll give you the mic, you know. Okay, all right. And then second to last, all of you, Those of you who make up the music ministry here and sang the choir with us this morning, that was an incredible experience. So thank you so much. And all the parishioners here, you've made our stay a wonderful visit. Could we give them a hand? Thanks to your sound team. And lastly, the singers behind me are people of faith as well, I think. And this whole group started in a very fortuitous way. It wasn't really planned. This opportunity just came and we just kind of jumped in. And we do it on very, very limited rehearsal times. We live all over the country and we come together and rehearse, and this is what you hear. They're so talented. Like, I wish I had the time for each of them to just sing a line. Gentleman on the piano, John, I can't thank you enough for being a part of this. And those of our members who couldn't be here today, I know they're looking on right now. One of our members who was supposed to be on the organ, Nathaniel, is a teacher, a staff member at Yale University, head of the chapel program. And, you know, Yale right now is like a fortress during this pandemic. And he came in. Through contact tracing, they had to get him tested and stuff. He took the first test, and he had to have two tests before he could leave. And the second test didn't come in on time. So he's at home all sad and gloomy. But he's joyous because we sang very well tonight. So, well, we have so many organists in the room, and Azriel did a phenomenal job just filling in today on organ. So, Azriel, thank you so much. Where are you? And John, I'm going to go to the last song. And Azriel, you know what? Let's do it with a piano, and you'll see why. John, put me in C major. Gosh, a song my granddaddy used to sing, try to sing, and it's a song that all of you know very, very well. And this is a singing church. I hear you all. So could you join me as we sing this last number?
Jerusalem, Jerusalem,
lift up your gates,
lift up your gates and see Hosanna in the
yourself, you sound beautiful. You go.
Just